Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to paint this nice little landscape here. So, stay tuned. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So, make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. So this is the underpainting, and I used oils for this stage here because I simply ran out of acrylics. Yeah. So this is the oil color for the background, three different blue tones as you can see. Let me start with the darkest tone on top. Let me go with the mid blue tone here, putting it on roughly more or less, and we blend it together with this broad blender brush here. I put in the lightest blue tone here. And now we put on the clouds, and these are pretty simple clouds, so we just brush the color in. It looks terrible now at the moment, but when you grab the blender brush, it pretty much soon starts to look like real clouds, fluffy and a bit washed out. Very soft. I put on now the darkest tone in the mountains and background. It's a pretty bluish color as you can see. And I go on with the mid gray tone here for the lighter tones in the shadows. Working my way back and forth. And already now leaving place for the snow that I will put on later. On the right side of the mountain here, I also use very thin down variations of this color here. Some purplish tones, some grayish tones here. Just to get this effect in. Now we put in the color of the snow. And we basically put in the snow with a very fine brush just over the whole thing, more or less. Just one color, and we basically put it on randomly where it would fit best. Also a bit thinning it out on the edges down here. Now we put in the color. Add the color of the snow in the shadows. As you can see, it's a pretty bluish color here, but it will look pretty realistic soon, as we'll see. Same goes here in the shadows part. This bluish color here from the snow. And pretty much soon starts to look pretty realistic. Same goes for the mountains in the background here. And for the mountain on the right side here, as you can see, putting on the white color first. The bluish color in the shadows. Yeah. Now we work on the first layer here with a fan brush. And we put it on, and we let the base color look through. The same goes with this part here, putting on the trees pretty roughly, and it looks not so well, therefore we have to start to blend them in to get this more washed out look from the distance. Same goes with this layer here. Different color scheme, but the same work-wise. Now putting on the color for the tree here, the foreground. Basically a pretty dark grayish bluish color here. And now putting on the mid-tone green color here, establishing this value here. Poking in some holes on the tree here, as you can see. and putting in the lightest color here. Establishing where I want to have this lightest tone here. And then we basically start to blend, more or less, putting in the mid greenish color here and the darkest color again. And then we start to put in the details that you need to have to get this thing looking really realistic. Same goes for the trees here, the right side here. And now we put in the grass. As you can see, I use the fan brush again with some very nice color variations, some really bright tones, some more reddish tones, some more greenish, darker greenish tones here, and I soften them down where I think it's necessary. And I go over this whole grass here and stipple on the color more or less to get this effect from this grass that you wouldn't achieve otherwise. And the same goes for this meadow here on the left side. Establishing the brightest value first and working the way in with some greenish tones and some reddish tones as well. And when you use the color and the brush lose a lot of color through this stippling, then you can use achieve an effect that the grass will fade out. Here I put in some more details with a fine brush here, and again with the fan brush some more details, working our way back and forth in there, getting some more detail. And we're finished. Ah, you want to see more? Then check out one of these two videos here.